Today is an almost inconceivable anniversary, 1 year on from the October the 7th atrocity. Let's think about one family, the Bibas family, who lived on the Near Oz kibbutz in southern Israel. Here is mother Cherie clutching her two boys as they were all taken hostage by terrorists on October the 7th. Kafir was only 9 months old and his brother Ariel was then 4 years old. I've seen video footage of this kidnapping, Cherie, the terrified mother, holding tight to her boys in terror, surrounded by armed monsters, taking them to who knows where. Cherie's husband, Yarden, was wounded in the head and also taken hostage separately. Her parents, the boys' grandparents, were murdered. The Israeli Defence Force verified video of Cherie and her boys alive in Gaza not long after the kidnapping. Hamas later claimed they'd been killed by Israeli bombs. Then some freed hostages reported seeing them alive. Right now, no one knows. 1 year on, a full year on, no one knows their fate. The Bibas family and 97 other hostages remain unaccounted for. We know some are alive, perhaps more than half of them. No one knows for sure. Who takes hostages? Who takes infants, children and mothers as hostages? What kind of a global and national debate do we have when their fate is not the number one priority, the first precondition for any talk of ceasefires or peace or resolutions? I put this badge of solidarity between Australia and Israel on my lapel on this show on the 6 month anniversary of October the 7th. I said then I'd leave it on until all the hostages had been returned. It's unforgivable and sickening to think it's now been a year of hell for those hostages, for their families, for their friends, and for their nation. Another inconceivable fact has come to our attention thanks to Janet Albrechtsen writing in The Australian on the weekend. She tried to find out how many Labor MPs, including the Prime Minister and Foreign Minister, had seen the video evidence of the Hamas atrocities. Now, I've seen much of this. It's horrendous barbarity and it's real-life trauma and I'm never going to be able to unremember it. I believed it was my duty to watch a lot of this, to understand what had happened in order to report on it properly and also satisfy myself that claims that were being made were accurate. But it seems from the non-answers given to Albrechtsen that our Prime Minister and Foreign Minister have not seen this evidence. I'm astonished. I'm staggered there wasn't a special viewing for the National Security Committee of Cabinet. It's an absolute abrogation of their responsibility not to view this crucial evidence, this gut-wrenching reality. You can't understand what's gone on. You can't comprehend Israel's terror, and you can't realise the hollowness of the claims made by the terrorists and their activist allies without seeing what they did. This wasn't resistance in the name of a Palestinian statehood. This wasn't part of a people's uprising. This was an Islamist extremist bloodbath, an orgy of violence and hatred that was perpetrated to inflict horror on Israel and to incite a war in Gaza that would inflict hardship and casualties on Palestinians. No wonder Albanese and Wong don't understand what's at stake. No wonder they see the issue like a university seminar on the aspirations of the Palestinian people. They haven't even bothered to properly inform themselves. We know they've failed the nation in their pathetic response to the conflict and in their weak response to hatred and anti-Semitism here in Australia. But it's even worse than we thought. A full year on, they've kept themselves deliberately ignorant.